Sabah everybody and welcome back to the channel. The Xperia Pro I was just announced a couple of days ago and I wanted to share with you guys what are some of the pro features that we have on a device like this that don't exist in other devices. Typically what we're talking about right now, we have a triple microphone setup with a 1-inch sensor that's centered in the back with Zeiss optics, which it allows us to actually have some great images as far as video and of course pictures. But not only that, I'm also talking about the ability of using an external monitor, external microphone system, also wireless remote, as well as a hand dock to be able to use it in a vlog style or distant if you want to do an interview with a couple of people. This is TK. Let's talk about some of the pro features in the Xperia Pro I. Like and subscribe and make sure you hit that bell icon so that you're always notified to whenever we have new videos on the channel. Now, the reason why you see so many things on the table is because I want to show you guys how to use this as a professional tool. This again is a pro device from Sony. This is the Xperia Pro I. Now, even though it's technically the successor to the Xperia Pro from last year, there are some differences here that we need to keep in mind. The triple camera setup that we have now is slightly different. We have a 16, a 24, and a 50 millimeter. And of course, you can see here that we have the 1-inch sensor now coming in from the RX100 Mach 7. The other thing that we also have here that's a little bit different than most devices is that we have an headphone jack that enables us not only to listen to music with a high quality DAC, but we also have the ability of using this as an audio source in, meaning while we're using the USB-C at the bottom, which by the way, we can also use USB-C audio here and as well as Bluetooth, typical to most devices, we're able to actually charge the device and use the audio in at the same time. Most devices now, since they don't have headphone jacks, we don't have the ability of doing that anymore. We also have dedicated keys, the ability of launching the camera app, the Video Pro app, as well as launching and stopping video directly with a dedicated button. Do the half press here to be able to do the focusing. So we can go ahead and press the button right now, open up the camera. And of course, we can initiate and start and stop video directly without having to touch the display. All of our controls work like a regular camera. And that's the beauty of how this is used. But what I want to share with you guys is that we can not only just use this as a camera, we can also use this as a monitor. And as long as you're able to route video over USB-C, you're able to actually use this as an external monitor. There's a monitoring app that you can turn on, connect it. And right now I'm just basically running the feed from the camera directly back in here. Of course, I can conversely change it over here and you can see me. I'm actually just using the overhead camera in my office right here. But the benefit of this is the ability of actually using this as an external monitor. It's a 4K monitor that can be used with any DSLR camera as a large on-the-go display to use for our video creation and consumption. The benefit here is that this is video in. This also supports video out, which means I can actually use an HDMI connector. And what I mean by this is that once we put this down, you'll notice right there I have an HDMI out. This is basically just an MHL, an USB-C to HDMI converter. You can buy your own personal one directly off of any of your favorite sites, but this is the one I ended up using. And also this one allows me to use external power to be able to also power my device, even though I'm using my USB-C to route video out. So we end up using this, using with the HDMI cables that we have here, male to male. And then, of course, we use something like this, display. Now, this is a Shinobi. This is a 4K display, so I can actually use the full potential of the output directly from the Xperia Pro, and I can use this as my external monitor. So that's what you guys saw in the thumbnail in the beginning of the video. Lastly, I'm also going to be using audio from an external source. So this is the Voico Lark X. This is a brand new system that I'm reviewing. It comes with its own case, and you're able to basically have two receivers. So here we have two transmitters, and then one receiver that you're able to charge directly in the box. Works great, looks great, and it keeps your equipment charged. But the benefit here is that I can actually use the connection here, which uses a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. And that means I can pretty much basically use this. This is going to be my audio out. This one features headphone jack as well as audio in for background music. So you can actually do a few more things with this. And of course, I'll be doing a full video on that. But the benefit of this is one actually now can connect it directly to the headphone jack on the outside. So now I have audio input from an external source and I can use this in my video camera application, be it Video Pro or even Cinema Pro. And of course, it goes without saying that you need some tripod equipment. So again, all of these things are pro tools. The last thing I shared with you guys in the last video is that we now have the ability of using the ZV-1 and the E10 grip to work with the Xperia Pro. They pair via Bluetooth and you're able to control it directly. Now, you can use it as a mount, meaning if you mount it directly like the camera setup that we saw directly from Sony, which has a smaller display, and unfortunately I don't have that one yet. But once you pair it, this becomes a Bluetooth remote that you can actually use to zoom in and zoom out, start and stop video, and of course, use this from a distance as we're going to do right now. So everything that you're seeing here, I'm going to put all of this together. Let's go outside and do a quick audio sample, audio and video sample, of course. One of the things I love doing is using a tool for what it's intended for. The Xperia Pro I is intended to be a pro tool with pro camera experience. One of the things I loved about it is the fact that we can actually use the grip. This is something that I've used with the ZV-1 or the ZV-E10. That's why I actually bought this one. And there is a kit that's going to work exactly with the Pro Eye that does the exact same thing with the external display, that little monitor that sticks to the back. But one thing I love about this is because this is connected via Bluetooth, and I'm using obviously the Voical Lark X here, that the microphones that I'm using wirelessly connected with the headphone jack with the TRRX connection. So therefore I have USB-C providing power, the headphone jack providing the audio input directly into the video camera application, and I can do this. I can actually control the zoom. Now, although I can't see myself directly, I do have that little monitor up there that gives me the ability of seeing exactly what's going on. I see that I'm centered, I see I'm in frame, and if I want to basically punch out, I could do the exact same thing and go all the way up. It's just expanding the possibilities of what we can do. The vlogging kit is going to work great when you're handheld and you're close, but you can also use it on a tripod, set it up to be a little bit further away, and have remote control functionality directly on your Xperia Pro I. And again, great audio with the Voical Lark X because it just works easily and you can actually have up to two microphones on this system. Now, as you saw there with the video, it absolutely looks fantastic. I was able to not only see what I was doing from a distance, I was able to control the zoom at the same time as well as initiate the video on this. Keep in mind that all of these things are utilizing the primary, the best sensor that we have here, the 1-inch sensor on the back of the Xperia Pro I. What I love about this is the capabilities that we have now. The vlogging kit that Sony has will include a smaller display. I decided to go with mine, which is a little bit bigger, and it's a 4K display, but their setup works absolutely just the same. It's even more minimalistic than what I was talking about here because it actually doesn't need an external power source the way my monitor does. So everything works really, really nice. And I think for the most part, literally this entire setup for interviewing up to two people, because the Voical Lark has two microphones, is very portable. And you can put this something like in a small Peak Design bag, carry it with you, and you don't have to carry bulky equipment. You're pretty much set to go. Fast 5G connectivity, 1-inch sensor on the back, and the only limit that you have here is your imagination. Set it up in whichever way you want. You either want to basically be the camera person, or you want to be the star or the actual person in front of the camera, and you can interview somebody else, and you can also see what's going on while you're using the best sensor on the camera. I think Sony has done a very decent job to tell us pretty much very blatantly, focus on the cameras on the back. Don't worry about the one in the front. We're giving you the best experience on the back. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Again, this is how to use the Sony Xperia Pro like a pro, and of course, get the best benefits of the brand new sensor that we have here. The Pro I, of course, is an amazing new experience, and I can't wait to get my hands on final production hardware, as this is still technically prototype early hardware. And of course, once we have access to that, I'll be doing a full review for you guys here on the channel. Like and subscribe as usual. Thank you very much to you and Sony for allowing me to check out the Xperia Pro I. I'll see you in the next video.